been drying for a couple of days. Now I'm ready to trim. I'm gonna show you how to trim it. First, I would get the this material is the, some people call it a bed grabber, that you put it underneath of your bed, and your bed is not going to slip away. You just add water to it. So place this right here on my wheel head, and then here is my bed, larger wooden bed. It's kind of large for that, but this is the only one I can find. So first I will center it. Okay, I'm approximately finding where I could place my ladder. Okay, it's about the size. But before I do that, I'm going to show you how to measure the thickness. Okay, before I trim, and I've been showing you my measuring tool. Okay, this tool, but you see that this the horizontal one is not long enough, but I still want to measure it. Okay, and here is a way to measure when you have something that is wider than the ruler itself. So basically, you could find two wooden board, okay? And this is very easy to get. You can get it from a hardware store that they use it for stirring the pan. So this wooden board, stirring stick, you can just place right here. Okay, and you can place your ruler right in the center. Just go there and check it. So the reading here is around 70. Okay. So from the top to the center, it's 70. All right, let me turn my wheel. And then you can take this to the side of it. So you can measure this. Okay. Let's pick it up. So it's about 90. So it's all on the same height. So you measure from the top of the ruler to the center and the top of the ruler to the bed. So if you subtract the difference, then it will be the thickness of the bottom of my platter. Okay, so this is how you do it. If you have something that is wider, still you can use the ruler to measure it. Okay, so we've got the thickness, it's about 20 millimeters. Okay, 20 millimeters. And I want to make a mark so I roughly know where to place my platter. Okay, not wide enough, make it a little bit wider. Some clay to hold it. Right. And then all you need to do is use a sharper tool to remove the clay. When you are trimming your platter, you're gonna trim it a little bit drier. The reason to do that is that you want the inside curve to hold the shape. If you trim it too wet and when your clay dry, the shape might change. Trim it when it's a little bit drier. And also, for the base like this wide, you might want to trim 2 foot rings instead of one. So one, if you have one ring here, you remove the clay in the middle has no support and it's easy to drop. So anything that you have a wider foot, you want to do maybe double rings. So this is my first one and maybe on my second one here. So I have one ring here and one ring here. The rest of it, you can just remove it. Okay, remove clay here, remove clay here. Remember that before I start to trim, I measure that thickness of the button is about 20 millimeters. And I'm aiming at the thickness of maybe leave about 5 millimeters on the button here. So it means that I could go down about 15 millimeters. So now it's only 5, so I can still go 10 more. Let's double check the thickness. Okay, so this is about 10, 11. So I can go 5 more millimeters. One more millimeter. So for the center, I will stop right here, about 15 millimeters, and then we use that as the guide to trim the outside part, so that the inside and outside looks, this part and this part looks the same. So I still have quite a bit of clay to dig from here. It's about 12, so we could still go 3 millimeters. So to double check it, okay, it is about 15 millimeters, so the thickness should be fine now. Okay, so now I'm just going to clean, trim that the line smoother. trimming. So I'll do the chattering mark right here. Sign my name and put a stamp. So if you want to flip the platter, you can sandwich it and then flip. So this is the platter that I finally trimmed with the foot, double foot ring, and chattering mark on the side of it. And this is the inside look like. And after we removed quite a bit of a clay, now it's much lighter. And also I told you that trim it a little bit drier, so the shape holds better when it's drying on the drying stage. Okay, so this is the chattering a large platter. Thanks for watching.